Well, this baby here is not really a baby.
Yeah.
50 years old. It's a 1968 Buick Riviera. 7,000 cc machine. 430 horsepower. V8. So it's not really a baby. It's a monster.
It's a monster of a car.
It's an American muscle car. Uh-huh. They call them American muscle cars.
So how long have you had it in Kenya, and what was the process of just bringing it to the Kenyan roads?
Well, I've had it for 3 years, but I'm based in Rwanda. Mm-hmm. I only brought it to Kenya on Wednesday. So it was a bit hard getting it past the Malaba border.
Yeah.
But it made it to the race course on Friday.
What speeds are we looking at, 0 to 100, and for the engine, how much are you spending on just fuel?
I'd be saying, I'm saying, spending about a K for 3 kilometers, something like that.
And 0 to 100?
0 to 100 in maybe 6 seconds.
And just take us, how was the process of restoration, and why choose the Buick Riviera to you?
Well, the Buick Riviera, when I look at the history of these cars, the American cars, around the same time, you had the Ford, the GM, so they usually had a competition of putting together beautiful muscle cars with some aesthetic designs that are so different. So I found the Buick designs really different and beautiful. You know, they just had their own designs. So if you look at the other Buicks even after this, they look really nice. So I thought it would be good to have one of these. Although I have a Chevrolet as well. I also have a Cadillac. But all these are being restored. Yeah, so this one is looks different from all of them.
Speaking about beauty, just take us inside so that we can see more of it.
Well, for this 1968 car, it's amazing you have this gear lever that looks like an aeroplane. It's an automatic transmission. Then you realize that it's all power windows.
Uh-huh.
In 1968, I couldn't believe they would do that. There's something else that is peculiar, that by design, it only came with one side mirror.
One side mirror.
By design. I tried to ask around, is there supposed to be a second side mirror? I said, no. Design for this car was one side mirror. Yes. The ACs work perfectly. Now the wipers, the power wipers. Yes. Well, that's pretty.
Pretty
basic. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, it's amazing for 1968 to be all power windows, automatic transmission. That's something interesting.
Yeah. And where do you take this baby when you're in Rwanda, let's say on a day to day? What's like here? What's the schedule for you when this beauty of yours?
Well, I drive it once a month. I play cricket, so I take it to cricket stadium.
The engine. Just tell us more about the engine.
Well, you see the engine is that's the size written up there, the 430. Something else that was interesting. The engine is the same big block the American car until that time all had that kind of engine. Yeah. Another peculiar thing is that you see these lights. Originally supposed to be reclining. And then they go down. The Porsches way back, these are mostly 68. They were supposed to go, which is, they're supposed to face upwards. That's something else that was interesting about it.
It does that.
They don't do that now.
I
switch off that function.
And Pete, how much do you use it before you replace
the battery? Well, I've only replaced it once. just because I kept about 3 months without riding it, I was out of the country. Yeah, but usually it's good. I use the powder kind of mattress.
Yeah. Are you looking at diesel or
petrol?
And what made you tell other guys who might be interested in this fashion or might be just want to assemble cars as a fashion?
Well, I think it's an interesting hobby, although people don't understand it, but it's always good to have a hobby like collecting something. People collect shirts, people collect watches.
Yeah.
So if you like cars, start working them, pick them up.
Yeah.
All spare parts are really cheap to get them online.
Yeah.
So, and of course, there's experts, you've got advice from many people around.
Yeah.
You can already restore these cars. They're good to keep, and finally you can always sell them for a fortune. It's an investment anyway.
Yeah. So we're looking at a really good investment for you.
Yes. It's an investment car.
Yeah. And lastly, what are we looking at winning today at Concours?
Well, I'm in a group of very hard cars to beat, but maybe something might come. You never know.
Never know.
Yeah.
Okay, that has been Paul taking us to the Buick Riviera. Cheers and thanks for having us.
Pleasure.